Hi, hello. We are going to have now a very brief introduction to the software using these slides. That it's just one of these ma many materials that you have on Canvas. So probably the first problem that you can face is to find Unreal. Usually, you have this shortcut. That goes here through Epic Games, and what is in this hub usually you will find here if you have or not already installed the Unreal. It should be already the in this case the 4.22 or the 4.20. It's interesting that you visit the marketplace at least once a month because you always get the free for the month stuff, which is very useful. In this case, for example, this last month, you have this ice cool packet in case you want to elaborate any kind of game or experience with ice. That could be interesting. But there's always many different tools that can be very useful. And then, of course, they are not free. There are other many other things in the marketplace that might be of your interest as well. But at least checking once a month the free stuff, I think it's a good practice, and also it gives you a lot of different ideas for your experiences. So, if you want to start working with this no friends, no, Unreal Engine, okay, and then you have to go to library, and here what you have is what this is what I bought, and you know, free for the month during the months. You have here the possibility of creating a new project or using any of the projects that you have been working recently. So you go to a new project. We go through. Okay, so we have here new projects, and I'm going to select the first person, or probably the third person, which I think it might be more useful. Then you have the possibility of creating that with static content and the maximum quality. Where are you going to save this? If you are working with a hard disk with USB, it might be a good idea to link directly that device here. So, but if not, you can always move the information once you have finished with it. Okay, for now we are going to create a third person project. Okay, so what you have when you create a third person project is what you see that usually starts with a complete prototype. Sometimes it is rendering the shadows, which is not the case. If you press play, you see that the game incorporates already many of the things, like for example the character, the possibility of jumping and moving the camera around with the mouse, okay, some objects, and also a basic stream of light, okay. But what you're going to do is start from zero. So press escape, okay. Then go to a new level, okay. And then if in the new level we are going to select empty level, okay. So what you see is a total empty level. And we are starting by creating the floor. Okay? Oh, the floor, a ground plane. So we are going to start with a very basic form of construction of level design, which is the geometries. Okay? In the old times, it was called BSP. Okay? But now it is called geometry. So you just need to drag one of these elements. I'm going to choose a box. Okay? When you choose the box, pressing the space, you can perfectly modify the shape of this, okay? And with that, we are going to create a ground plane that it is of our, you know, interest. It's something like this. It should work. Okay. So right now it's difficult to see exactly the dimensions we need, but you will get to that. The all important thing now is that if you use the space bar, okay, with the object selected, you can move from the different modes of transformation of the piece, okay? So then later what we are going to do is to create the reference of a character, okay? And so, well, one, if you are using the other project, which is should be here in maps, okay, this one. If you go to that third person example map, the one that we have been playing before, you will see that, well, you can use the mannequin, the figure, and that is pretty good to calculate the different. So one thing that we can do is import one of these characters as well. Okay, so you select empty character. Okay, yeah, this is the reference of the size. Okay, if we go to F, okay, we select F, this is the measure of the human scale, more or less, to the standard, but you don't see anything there, because you don't have the mesh of the character, which if you want, you need to drag directly from the third person blueprint. Okay, so if you import here, here we are, this probably is the best way of having a reference. Okay, so that is a way of starting constructing our scenario. Okay, another possibility is creating a reference using a cube, but instead of using this cube, we can use a geometry. Okay, the difference between this cube, okay, and this other, which would be the geometry. Well, basically, this is an asset. So, in this case, this is a mesh. This is imported, and I have all this information. What you have here is more a kind of a brush. Okay. So you can extract or to add to this mesh and little by little construct it a more sophisticated piece. The way the information is rendered in this geometry is usually more demanding, so it is not usually recommended to do everything with geometry, which is a pity because it's very easy, very convenient, and it's very fast. But you usually don't want to work with geometries all the time, because as I say, it's very demanding, okay, for the machine calculations. Okay, so we have these two things there. As I say, if you go here to the properties, you can select here in the scale directly and select the most appropriate ones. Okay, so imagine that you keep this to 1, 1, and 1. That would be a box, okay, that has the same value in the three dimensions. But what you can do there later here in the brush settings is to be a little more exact about that. So you can do something like 60 in the X, okay, 60 in the Y, and then keep the set to 180, okay? So that would be more or less what a person, a tall person could be, you know? If you go here, you compare, well, this is slightly taller than the character, you know? So any of these methods is perfectly fine to start creating your scene, okay? So another element that you might need, or you are going to need for sure, is the light. Okay, So there are different kinds of light in Unreal, so it is important to combine them, understand how they all interact. Everything related to light is going to be here. So it is these kinds of different light. Okay, we are going to start with the directional light. The directional light can be similar to what a spotlight could be, but it's more kind of intended to be replicating the natural light, like from the sun. Okay, so you just drag one, and in the moment you drag one, you see that it's already affecting the whole scene. Okay, you can modify the rotation of that. Okay, so depending on the angle, okay, in relation to okay, so it would be simulating this way the different hours of the day. Okay, so if you go to the light details here on the details, you can modify intensity. For example, it is measured in lux. Okay, so you can modify slightly the color. Okay, or not that slightly, in order to create a special effect with light. Like for example, oh, I want a tungsten, or I want, I don't know, like a spotlight, very warm. You know, it's up to you. If not, you work with white light. Okay, another possibility is to work directly with the variable, which is called temperature. Okay, and it's usually here, temperature. So if you use temperature, you can use these photographic values, okay, where it is using the color temperature using Kelvin degrees. Okay, so there are other variables, but I'm not going to enter specifically on that. It's using cast shadows is important. If you don't cast shadows, it won't produce any shadow on the object, so probably you need those. Okay, so you can modify the light intensity and the color. That's something that you can explore as well using the slides. And then we have the atmospheric fog. The atmospheric fog is not in light, it's in visual effects. Okay, so you just drag on atmospheric. Okay, and you would see there is an horizon, and that affects to the quality of light. Okay, another thing you need to add when you add a light always is the skylight. Okay, so that way this reflects better on the surfaces and create more soft shadows. So you need to add always this component as well. Okay, and what else? Yeah. Okay. Well, if you want to add, you want to test your screen and you play now, well, you see that the player just goes down. Okay. To avoid this, you need to create a player start, which is the position of the character in the new. In the new game, so that way you can create, for example, here, whatever, and so that is basically a very good idea. And it's again in basic in this shortcut, and you have player start, so you have put it here. So as I say, here it is where the character is going to start. So it starts here, and with that, well, you can test a little your screen to see, well, if the objects are creating the effect that you want. Okay. Another basic element when you are creating scenarios, any kind of level design, is the light map importance volume, the light volumes in general. This is here on volumes. Okay. If you don't see that, you can always, write that light map importance, or the light mask volume, sorry. Okay, so this is the volumetric light map density volume. Okay, so what is this? Basically, it's saying inside this, this software is going to render some specific properties for the line. So you usually want your scenario to have that, you know, corresponding to the entire room or the entire cave or the entire part of the scenario that you want to render separately. Okay, so you usually want that to be adjusted to the okay to the scenario that you are playing with. Okay. This point might be important to understand how you move around a little better. So for example, as I say before, you select any object and you go to F, it goes directly to the object. It could be very useful. Okay, you can do that as well going through the word outliner, which is here. If you don't see that, you have to select word outliner, the window word outliner. So it is because probably it's hidden. This happens unfortunately a lot. If you want to go to this object, you just select F, F, F for focus, and you go directly to the object. Okay, you can use the scroll of the mouse, okay, to go closer, or go farther. If you modify this camera speed, okay, it will be slower the way it is, but also the way you move around. So when you use, for example, the arrows to move, you can use the arrows, okay, the up, down, okay, left and right to move, and you can also tilt the camera, okay, with the right button, okay, and you can pan with the left button, and with that it should be enough to move. Okay, as I say, modify this to your convenience. This is related to the scale. Again, if you want to work to a lower level to detail, so higher level of details, sorry, but you might want to be, you know, manipulating this scale, just selecting more accurately values. Okay, so with that, it should be fine. And yeah, and well, and another good idea when you start is always deactivating the autosave. This might seem, you might think it's not important, but it is in fact quite important. Because when you are doing things and you don't know exactly what you're doing, sometimes you do something that for accident is just erasing something that you actually wanted to keep in the level, something that actually worked. And if you want that to be restored, it is not going to be possible if it's saving all the time. So it is better to deactivate the saving. Okay, so you go, let's see what it is, because with this time, sometimes maps and modes, no, what is it? Okay. All settings. Okay, so let's see if I find that safe. No, it is not. Well, it's not in the project settings. It must be on the preferences. Sorry for that. So if you go to preferences, you have loading and saving, and then I would suggest to deactivate everything that has to do with autosave. Okay, that way you just will save when you want and where do you want and with the name you want. Okay, so let's test. Okay, save the map. Okay, another thing, well, this is just a basic introduction, so I think it would be a good idea to save it as it is. You might observe here a message, lighting needs to be rebuilt. That is where, because when we add elements that are affecting the lights, sometimes the computer wants to do some operations, wants to update the result of that. So you can select build or build all, okay? And yeah, after some seconds, imagine, depends on how many new things you have been including, you will receive a message. Okay, this is normal. Map check complete, 0 errors, okay, so everything is fine. Sometimes a little annoying, so you have to get used to that. And with that, you can save again, because that way everything is computed. And if you play, you can now see the result of your very, very, very basic level design, okay? So let's see what we find in the next one.